Good Sunday evening, everybody. Live and direct from downtown Memphis, Tennessee, I'm meteorologist Austen, Onek with a quick check of what's going on in and around the Mid-South area for tonight as we wrap up the weekend and head into next week. Unfortunately, you're probably going to have to keep the umbrella handy or, again, in and around the area because we are going to be seeing more chances of showers, not complete and total washouts, but we are going to be seeing, again, those chances of showers sticking around parts of the Mid-South into the course of the next couple of days. If you've never joined us here before for our video weather blog called Weather Overtime, forecast in the bottom portion of your screen, and all you have to do to check out the forecast is go to this website address, WREG.com/weather, for an update as to what's going on in and around the Mid-South. It is Sunday evening. It is Earth Day. A very happy Earth Day to you. And looking, again, at some quiet conditions out there for right now, we do not have any severe weather to talk about. Good news on that. If you'd like to drop your locations, your city, state, and whatever weather reports you've got, rain gauges, if you have that, would be a good one to note for tonight. Anything in the way of winds or rainfall out there, we'd love to know a little bit more about what's out there for that. And if you've got anything in the way of weather pictures, go ahead and tweet them to me at aonic_WREG3, or you can post them on my Facebook page as well. We've got a few new pictures out there we'll take a look at tonight, mostly just cloud cover across much of the Mid-South, but again, more on that coming up here in just a little bit. Over the course of the next few hours, temperatures will be falling, but again, we're not talking about an Arctic blast back in the mid to upper 50s as we head into the very early morning hours of Monday, so not really seeing too much of anything major taking place at this time where it comes to huge amounts of temperature drops out there. It will be cool, and it might be a little breezy into the morning hours, so we'll see, again, more chances for rainfall out there for now. Alice McGowey, Wyatt, Mississippi, is the rain over? Not yet, and going to be sticking around for a while. Scott Bullard, is spring going to arrive later this week? Yes, actually, we'll be seeing a lot better conditions out there for right now. Charles Puncho Gunter, U of M area, a bit on the warm side. Thank you very much. And John Michael, 63 degrees from Bartlett. Thank you very much for that weather report out there. Into the rest of the Mid-South forecast, again, the information on the blue bar at the bottom of your screen. Nutshell forecast here for overnight. Temperatures dropping again, not by much, mid to upper 50s by the time we hit daybreak. And there will be some scattered chances of rain, not a washout, but if you are traveling tomorrow morning, I would allow for a little bit of extra time and a lot more space between you and the vehicle in front of you. Wet roadways right now, West Memphis, Arkansas, the Kroger parking lot, I-40, I-55 traffic over here. Live picture showing again some wet conditions in and around West Memphis for this evening, and seeing again some pretty decent amounts of rainfall out there for tonight. We've already picked up more than a couple of inches in parts of the Mid-South. Downtown Memphis, again, a lot of some decent amounts of rainfall out there across the area for right now, and you can almost barely see right in the middle of your screen the Big River Crossing doing its hourly animation, top of the hour animation going on right there, but kind of difficult to see through the haze and the mist out there for this evening. But again, more chances of rain for right now. Not getting much of anything in the way of rain at Poplar Pike and Germantown, in and around the area of the Germantown City Hall camera. 64 degrees, nearly an inch and a half of rainfall in the rain gauge, and easterly winds at about 10 miles per hour, but the rainfall still kind of making its way toward the eastern part of Shelby County for tonight. Showers and a few rumbles of thunder, the bright kind of asterisks right here, that's where we're showing the lightning strike showing up, so we are getting some rumbles of thunder out across much of the Mid-South. This one, again, right back into around the area close to around Cuba, Bengistown, north of the northwest part of the loop area between Millington and Memphis, getting a couple of lightning strikes here. And that's what we've been seeing throughout the rest of the evening on Storm Tracker 3S radar, just some isolated activity. Heaviest showers by far. Excuse me one second here. Okay, hang on just a moment. We're getting... Sometimes the computer gets a little bit cranky when the fingers get a little bit too close to the screen. There we go. Okay, now, gently for a second. There we go, hopefully. There. Sorry, technical difficulties. They happen from time to time. As of right now, looking again at the heaviest showers around the southwest part of the 55 loop, West Memphis down to about South Haven over Whitehaven, picking up a couple of cells worth of activity. But once again, we do not have anything severe taking place. We have had a decent amount of rainfall over parts of northeast Mississippi, and this has been going on for the last few hours. More sporadic stuff over here in eastern Arkansas and northwest Mississippi, but those occasional lightning strikes showing up. Hughes, Marvel, back toward Forest City, some decent amounts of lightning showing up in and around the area here just to the west of Tunica, Mariana, south and west of Hughes, getting some pretty good lightning in that location. And once again, no severe weather, but we could see an occasional strong storm from time to time as this whole system begins to make its way through the area. It's not in any hurry to go anyplace. The jet stream is not really kicking this thing out anytime soon, so it's going to wander on through the Mid-South throughout the rest of the evening tonight, and that'll give us more chances of rainfall right on into tomorrow morning. So again, we're going to be looking for some more chances out there for rain out there. So Charles Morgan running 5 miles in the morning. Technically, yes, but you're going to have that rain to deal with out there, so plan ahead for that out there. I'll be cheering you on from the couch, so good luck to you. A few marathoners in my wife's family, but again, cheering them on from the couch as well on that, so thanks a lot for checking in. Channing Kidd, is it going to rain tomorrow? Depends on your location. Thank you very much for that. Southwest Memphis, Jerwin Johnson Macklin, thank you very much for checking on in. So again, a little bit of pouring down there. And Vivian Bolden, North Memphis, not doing much here. Okay, very good. Thank you very much on that. For those of you who are just checking in, again, we're looking at some scattered showers out there. 58 degrees in Dyer, Tennessee. Trey Harris, thank you very much for that one. Celia Horton Lair, raining in Henderson and all day as well. Thank you very much on that one. And Charles Morgan, thanks, but I'm not him. I'm somebody else. But thank you very much for, again, that on there. 3 inches plus in and around the area of Lee County School District in Marianna, Arkansas, and well over an inch of rainfall across much of the area. And temperatures, again, pretty much on the mild side, not dropping down much more than this. If you'd like this information on your computer system, all you have to do is go to this website address, WREG.com/weather, and click on the WeatherBug icon for more up there, and you can get live, real-time, as it happens, weather information from across the Mid-South. Here's what it looks like, again, running the numbers into tonight. News Channel 3 at 10, storm system swirling on through, some minor mini vortexes stirring up the possibility of maybe a rumble of thunder, but our threat for severe weather tonight is basically all but gone. We'll talk about that in just a little bit. Now, into tomorrow morning, very early about the time News Channel 3 Todd Demers is on the air with Daybreak tomorrow. Todd will be giving you a little bit more of the showers and maybe a rumble of thunder, but I think mainly we're just going to be looking at rain. Either way, tomorrow morning you're going to have to save some extra time to get to where you're going because of the fact that we're going to have some more wet roadways out there. And of course, remember that if your windshield wipers are operating and it's daytime, your headlights have to be on. So let's make certain we all stay safe out there throughout the rest of the day. Dropping the kids off at school, picking them up again, there will be more chances of rainfall across the Mid-South area, and continuing that right on into tomorrow evening. Then we finally start to work our way out of the rainfall as we get into very early on Tuesday morning when some drier air makes its way on through. It's going to be a brief respite from the rain, but at least we'll get something out there to kind of knock the rainfall off for right now, so not really seeing that much of a huge problem. The threat for severe weather yesterday went way up into the Mid-South area. That was curtailed earlier today, and the good news is it looks like the main threat for severe weather is now way away from us, east of Pensacola, down south of Atlanta, down to around the Florida Panhandle, extreme southeastern Alabama, southwestern Georgia, picking up a slight risk category, marginal threat up to around Birmingham, into around Montgomery. For the Mid-South area, this pale green color that you see here, my tracker would work there. That's all we're looking at for right now. It's just the possibility of isolated thunderstorms. No severe weather being seen at this time, so very quiet out there for the time being. And again, severe weather threat pretty much gone for at this point, so not really looking too bad there. Lower 60s with isolated showers tomorrow. And that's going to be about all that we see in the way of anything involving activity of heavier nature. So we're really kind of starting to turn the tap off, but we don't turn the rain showers off entirely until we go, unfortunately, into later on this week. Now, the showers and thunderstorm chances here have been kind of fluctuating over the last couple of computer model runs. Late Wednesday, a chance of showers off and on Thursday, again on Friday. Maybe a rumble of thunder by early Saturday morning, but then getting rid of the rain showers out there. And add to this, for those of you who have been looking for less in the way of frosty conditions, you've got out that out there, no question about that. Out goes the frost, and in comes some very mild temperatures. Now, we may see some upper 40s by the time we hit about next Sunday morning with some clearer, drier air coming on through, But for right now, it looks a lot better across the Mid-South where it comes to anything involving frost, not much of anything else. Very mild temperatures, upper 70s to lower 80s by next Monday and Tuesday as we wrap up April and head into May. Where has the time gone? And looking again at maybe another chance of showers by next Wednesday into early May with temperatures back in the mid-70s, but a very slight chance of rain, very far in advance, more of a suggestion at this point, but we'll watch that throughout the course of the rest of the weekend, so stay tuned for more on that. Thanks to Mr. James R. Gulledge, frequent contributor on News Channel 3's Weather Picture segment, for a nice view of some of the foliage in and around Humboldt, Tennessee, and 75 degrees around Saturday, so a beautiful day there. If you've never had a chance to listen to him before, I urge you to check out Chu Violin, Jonathan Chu, Memphis resident, all-around nice guy, and musician extraordinaire. Caught a great shot of some storm clouds around Midtown Memphis just a couple of days ago, so a great opportunity to see some of his photographic skills. He's on tour with Kerry Job and a band I've never heard of before called Skillet, so apparently he's on tour decently with that. His wife and my wife work together on some clothing ventures, so again, a little bit of an opportunity to work together here. Real nice guy, and opportunities again for a lot of great music on there. Follow him on Twitter for some great duets with himself, if you've never seen that before. From Arkansas, SEC 73, some storm clouds around Crowley's Ridge, close to Colt, Arkansas for today, so a little bit on the unsettled side out there today, but no severe weather to report at this time, so definitely good news on that. More of your pictures on these segments, send them to me, Aonic underscore WREG3 on Twitter, Aonic no underscore necessary, WREG3 on Instagram, and on my main Facebook page at Austen Onek WREG. You can also catch my forecast throughout the rest of the weekend on Country 92.5 and Oldies 102.3. And of course, I'll be back on with Bob and Josh early tomorrow morning on News Channel 3's forecast on AM 730 Talk Back Live with Bob and Josh. You can listen in for some great sports chat going on, including some political debate coming up on Tuesday, if I'm not mistaken. I believe they're having the some of the candidates for the sheriff's position, if I'm not mistaken. So you can tune in and listen more on there. And again, if you can't listen online, listen online at talkbacklivenetwork.org. That's Monday through Friday from 8 to 10. And don't forget, Todd Demers will be on with your complete forecast bright and early tomorrow morning on News Channel 3 Daybreak. Jennifer Blackwell, too much rain, baseball season. Yeah, I'm looking forward to the Redbirds coming back into town pretty soon, hopefully. Diana Stacy, 60 degrees in Blytheville. Thank you very much for that one. Deborah Brock, welcome to the show. Rain go away from Bobby Doles. I think a lot of people are repeating that sentiment for tonight. Thank you very much for that one. Diane Sangster from Brownsville, welcome to the show. And Devendry Tate, there's a similar feeling right there. Rain, rain, go away for right now. Kara Lady Boss Phillip, when is the sun coming back again? Off and on over the next few days. Not by much at this point in time, unfortunately, for right now. Teresa Pierce Conway, pouring in Salisbury, Tennessee. What about school? As in school outings and closings? We don't have any, and as far as I know, they don't close school for rainfall anytime soon. There's no flash flooding for that particular area, as far as I know, for right now. Charles Morgan, yes, Jonathan Chu, great guy, great photographer, more talent in his little pinky finger than I will ever have in my entire life when it comes to music. So, yes, very nice to see that. Diversa Harvard Brown, you can contact Markova Reed through our website. You can go to this address, just leave off the weather, WREG.com. Scroll down to the bottom of our page and you can see the info section, or you can click on the News Channel 3 People section. You can contact her through there. She's also on Facebook, also on Twitter, on many other social media networks as well, if you'd like to get in contact with her there. So thank you very much for that one. Stephen Petty from Cleveland, Mississippi. Thanks to Charles Puncho Gunter for the very nice words. And everything good in Senatobia now, Michaela Baldwin. Not too sure if that's referring to weather or something else, but as far as I know, yes, at this point in time it is. Kevin Scalliams, Brighton, Tennessee, 63 degrees. I'll have more on the forecast, including a look at weather where the troops are, coming up here in just about 15 minutes on my Facebook page. You can get there by going to facebook.com/AustenOnekWREG, and I'll be on Periscope and Twitter for those of you who are not on Facebook. Thanks to everybody for joining me for tonight. for our Sunday evening edition of News Channel 3's exclusive video weather blog, Weather Overtime. If you got anything in the way of suggestions, we'd love to hear them. Send me pictures that you see around the Mid-South. Just drop them to this email address at austen.onek@wreg.com. We'd love to hear from you to see what you might have out there in the way of suggestions. Again, join me at about 8:35 for a complete update of weather where the troops are and another look at your forecast for the rest of into next week. And we'll take a look at some more of the weather pictures out there if anybody sent anything in out there. And join us again at 10. Kristen Holloway has all the day's news. Mike Sadie has a look at sports. And of course, yours truly with an update of your News Channel 3 forecast. That's on News Channel 3 at 10. Live and direct from downtown Memphis, Tennessee, I'm meteorologist Austen Onek from the WREG News Channel 3 Severe Weather Center. Stay tuned for a lot more with News Channel 3 on air and online throughout the rest of the weekend and right on into next week.